at the moment, more than 50,000 people left jobless, are left jobless in Macedonia, although the government gave organized four economical packages to support employment and to support small businesses. And also, thousands of businesses are working at the edge, and we don't know what will happen in the next future. Politically, the COVID crisis is a test for democratic capacity of the leadership and society in general. And I can say that Macedonia passed this test pretty good. The freedom of speech is guaranteed and kept through electronic and social media, through the parliamentary debate, through local councils, and everywhere. So there are, of course, all kinds of talking, constructive and not constructive, true stories and fake news. But what is important is that the mainstream of these talkings, of these debates, is democratic and open-minded, and it prevailed. So this is very important. Macedonian government succeeded to handle the crisis somehow, even very good in the beginning, from March to June. And the hero, let's say, in brackets, of this period was the Minister for Healthcare, who got over 80% of trust by the citizens, because he was extremely transparent, and he was giving information each day on press conferences and answering along to each question from the journalists, and the journalists were connected with the citizens, who also could ask questions through them. So this procedure was very important to make people calm, to make calm in this difficult situation. So even this lockdown was passed on a relatively normal way, believing that the people believe that they're doing something that is good for common good. When we speak about hate speech, in general, I must say that the news about COVID are shared in our country on a transparent way constantly, with precise details. We didn't hide the number of infected and passed away as in some other countries. Opposite of it, our authorities even counted COVID as COVID victims, those who died from different reasons, but that were post-mortem found out that they were infected.